to pitch. Swing and a miss, and he strikes out. But you know what? He made it back. He got his run back, and the crowd comes to its feet again. He had his hacks, and R.A. Dickey pitched him like a big leaguer. Well, that's what R.A. Dickey said. When Dickey was asked how he would approach Greenberg, Dickey didn't miss a beat. He said, I will pitch him like the big league hitter that he is. He may be the only big leaguer in history with a smile that wide after striking out. That dancing knuckleball that stayed up in the zone and just took off. But he had two good hacks on those last two knuckleballs. Good for him. At 31, he would like to make a comeback. He did not play this year. He had shoulder surgery after playing in the independent league. He started a business, but he started to train midway through the season. Played with Israel on the World Baseball Classic team. Rich, in a nice article, someone who was very instrumental in kind of his comeback and also his establishing himself just as a citizen and a businessman, Dusty Baker. And Dusty Baker was his manager with the Cubs the night he was hit on July 9th. And Baker kept in contact and kept pushing him, kept, whenever the phone would ring, picking up the phone, whenever he thought Greenberg needed a lift. Baker would reach out. And it was Dusty Baker that actually told Greenberg, look, you have a family now. You might want to start your business. And it's a computer business. Start your business and then think about coming back. So that's what he's done. He's started a business. And now he's trying to make that comeback.
Well, you mentioned his parents are here, his wife, other family members, many, many friends.
On a strike to Jose Reyes. And it's fun to watch the Marlins players, the other big league players, embrace Greenberg, because there are some big league players, there are fans, there are executives that said no to Adam Greenberg, that said, you know what, I don't want any part of this. But the Marlins players, to their credit, accepted him into the clubhouse, hazed him a little bit. I think they made him sing a karaoke song.
Just a little rookie hazing, yeah.
And they had a great time with him during batting practice. They all fell apart when on his last batting practice swing, he hit one out of the park. And Reyes dumps this one into left center field for a base hit.
I tell you what, Jose Reyes came into this game 2-for-23 against R.A. Dickey. He has two hits tonight. Reyes, 2-for-3.
See, what the Marlins need to do right now, Tommy, they need to hit around. But with two outs, obviously, that's probably not going to happen. Dickey's been tough. The Marlins have been able to get him for two solo homers, Wilkes Hernandez and Rob Brantley. Emailers, John just logged one our way.
Carlos Zambrano with the Cubs at that time, not pitching that night.
Reyes is running. Stanton lines it in the left field. That's a base hit.
couple of hits back to back. Carlos Lee is the hitter. I know throwing a knuckleball is not as strenuous as throwing 95 mile an hour fastball, but Dickey's workload is different, I think, than the Tim Hitfields and the Phil Negros, even the Charlie Huffs, because he throws a hard knuckleball. He has a little more stress on his body than on his arm.
I think if you just close your eyes and you picture Charlie Huffs and Wakefield and Phil Negro, if you remember how he used to throw it, it was a much easier and it was a slower knuckleball. You're right. What more stress already hit, you know, over 235 innings this year.
Dickey misses in, almost got Carlos Lee. He has popped out and has fly down.
But tonight, so far, R.A. Dickey's been outpitched by Jacob Turner.
And you can see the strategy that Ozzie Guillen used to get Greenberg in the ballgame rather than lift Turner, who's pitching well. He pinch hit for Brian Peterson, he can insert Scott Cousins into that spot and go from there.
I'll tell you the other thing that was probably on Ozzie's mind in trying to get Adam Greenberg in the game. If you wait till later, all of a sudden you might get a matchup and Terry Collins is going to go to a left-hander to pitch to Greenberg, and you don't want him to have that at bat against a lefty. And Ozzie, I thought, played it well. Pinch hitting for Peterson and can use Cousins in left field.
Chopper towards third and it's fouled. Two and two. Manny Acosta in the Mets pen.
All of a sudden in this inning, you've seen more knuckleballs that have a little less dance to them and more that have been up in the strike zone. That might have been a fastball, not over the plate.